Coach Smith, and I want to give you four good tagging games. You may have heard of some of them. We like to play these at Baker, and some of them are old. I've had them for a while, but some other ones are some new ones, so maybe you can take a tidbit or a nugget and apply it to your games that you are already playing. So a couple of things. Number one, we have to play in partners in my gym. It's just not big enough and it's not safe. Our numbers are big. So we always play tag games with a partner. So you will see these cones here and we have them all around the gym. So one partner is playing while one is resting. Now, you can have that partner do some sort of exercise while they wait, but oftentimes in our tagging games, they're tired. And so they use that as a rest or a break. And then when it's time to go in, they will switch with their partner. So I'm going to give you four games. We're going to talk about pizza party. We're going to talk about pancake tag. We're talking about noodle tag and toe tag. So you may have heard of those before. We've tweaked some of them, especially to work with our younger kids. So let's get started. So the first activity I wanted to tell you about is called pizza party. We call it pizza party because our kids love pizza and it gets them excited. You can also call it angry waiters. Speedy waiters, anything you want, but we like to tell them that we are going to be delivering some pizzas and have a pizza party. So the way that we first start out is our palm is up, you put the poly spot on top and you are balancing that. Now, with our kindergartners, we did not initially start out playing tag. We just had them walk around and we were all silly waiters and we talked about what type of flavors we had for our pizza. Was it pepperoni or was it cinnamon sugar dessert pizza? And they had a blast doing that. So, but the older kids, first through fifth, they would then go around and try to flip the pizza off of someone else's hand. Now, you have to be careful to make sure that the students do not put their pizza by their face, because then A, they might get hit in the face with their pizza, or B, someone trying to flip the pizza might hit them in the face. So we tell them, you have to get it away from your body like a waiter, and they are carrying it around just like this. Now, a couple different ways that you can get out. One is if your pizza falls down, you're out for any reason. Maybe it just fell because you weren't balancing it well, you're out. If it gets flipped off, you're out. And if you go out of bounds, you are out. Now, once we play that for a few rounds, then we will say, oh my goodness, our pizzas are getting a little hot. We're gonna have to turn that hand over. And so now our palm is facing down and it's a little bit harder to balance. So we will play that round for a little while and then we will say, okay, you can have 3 points of contact. So you might do 2 fingers and a thumb. You might choose to do 3 fingers, but you can only have 3 points of contact. And so then it gets a little bit harder for them to balance. And then the last way we play is 1 finger and they're like, woo, and they get all excited. And they say, we can't do that, but they learn that they quickly can and they balance it. We do have to be careful with telling them not to make sure that they're cheating by grabbing the outside of their poly dot, but they do a good job. And especially once they get started and they see that they can actually do it. So, and it does slow them down because at this point they're pretty excited and it does get them to kind of slow down a little bit. Now we have also done an elimination round where everybody in the class starts with the pizza, depending on the way you want to do it. Maybe it's palm up, and then if they get out, we move to the volleyball court. Let me say that. We move inside the volleyball court. And once they're out, say the pizza falls, I pick it up. And now I am walking on our track, which is outside our volleyball court. And they're just walking laps until we get down to a few people. When we get down to a very small number, we will move it inside the circle and it makes it really hard. And so they love that as just kind of a last elimination game. You do not have to do that if you don't like to do elimination games. But like I said, it adds a little bit of excitement. So that is pizza party. Hope you enjoy it. It's a great one and our kids have really enjoyed it. So the next one is called pancake tag. Now, the pancake tag, we use the lollipop paddles, which are so much fun. Our kids love these. If you don't have any lollipop paddles, then you can use a ping pong paddle or a tennis racket, anything that you can use as a pan that you can flip. We use the poly spots, but if you have a bean bag, you could use that too. So with our younger kids, we do not actually play the tagging part of this game. We keep it super simple, and I was amazed at how much fun they had. So with our littles, kinder and first, and we start out with second and third as well, just practicing a flip. So we will tell them, okay, you're gonna take 5 steps, and then you're gonna try to flip your pancake. So it looks like this. So they would start out, and they would be like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then they stop, they try to flip it. Now we tell them not to flip it too high. If you flip it too high, it's harder to catch. So if they do not catch it, they simply carry it back to their partner and it's their partner's turn. If they are successful and they flip it, then they get to walk five more steps. They walk five more steps and flip. As long as they are making it, they are in the game. And I will tell you, there's a lot of drops at the beginning, but y'all, they had so much fun just doing that. So definitely try that with pancake tag with the little ones. But with our older kids, we had them practice that for just a few minutes so that they could get familiar with the flipping of the pancake. And then we played our pancake tag. Same rules, you have to be inside the blue lines and you are trying to knock someone's pancake off of their skillet. Now, if it does fall off, then you're gonna carry your pancake back. You're gonna do one flip or two flips, it's up to you, and then hand it to their partner. So the pancake flipping is not part of the actual tagging game. It's more like the pizza party game where you're trying to knock it off. You can also turn your skillet sideways and see if you can balance that way. That's a lot harder. And remind them to keep them away from your body. But that is pancake tag. If you don't need partners, you could have them simply come out, do a couple of flips or an exercise, and then they're back in the game. So pancake tag, super duper fun. So with noodle game, every team is going to need a noodle. So we have the noodles that are cut in half. You can use the longer noodles, totally up to you. Now, this is noodle tag, it's pretty simple, you've probably heard of it. And we also tweak this to do candy cane tag. So during your holidays, we just change the name and the kids think it's a different game, but we have Star Wars tag and we have candy cane tag. I linked candy cane tag below because we kind of changed the way the noodles look. But overall, noodle tag, pretty simple. There are four ways that we say that our kids can get out. Now, when you're playing noodle tag, we tell them that they've got to tag below the waist. So if you get tagged below the waist, you're out. If you tag someone and you tag too high and maybe you tag them above the waist, you're out. If you go out of bounds, so for us is our basketball court, which is our black lines. If they go out of bounds, they are out. And then fourth one is, if you don't go the speed limit, you're out. And we do start off with a speed walk or a walk just to kind of get started. They're all excited, amped up. We want to make sure that they are being safe. So when you are out for any of those reasons, you simply raise the noodle above your head and you walk it over and hand it to your partner. Now, if your noodle is in the air, everyone that's playing is not going to tag you because they know that you are out. And so I don't know about you, but our kids get frustrated when they're out and they're taking it back to their partner and they keep getting tagged. So that was one way that we solved that is hand in the air. Everyone knows you're out and you hand it to your partner. Now, if your classes are so big that you have a lot of people or maybe you want to run it a different way, you can have one cone where if you're out, you simply bring it to the front of the line and give it to the person in line and then go to the end of the line so that you have one cone designated for the line, and every time you're out, that's where you take your noodle. We've done it that way in the past as well, so you can do it either way. So this is noodle tag. So another super fun game is called beanbag tag or toe tag. Now you may have played it before. It's a game that I played long ago and kind of have brought back after a coworker had suggested it at an in-service. So it's a simple game. Everyone can have a beanbag if you play that way. Or again, with our large classes, we have a partner. So one is waiting by the cone, the other one comes out, and we play a couple different ways. We start out by saying that if you're in bounds and you have your beanbag, you can't move. And you are trying to slide it on the floor and trying to tag someone on the toe. Now, if you throw too high, which is up in the air at all, then you're out. If you get tagged, you're out. If you go out of bounds, you're out. And I think that's about it. Now, if you're out, you simply put the beanbag above your head because that's how we know in my class that you are out, and you carry it back to your partner, hand it to your partner, and then it's their turn. Now, you can also play where if you have your beanbag, you can move around. So there's lots of movement. They are sweaty and drenched after playing, and they really enjoy it. Now, I will tell you on one thing, that we make them keep the same beanbag. So if I throw my beanbag, slide it across the floor, I have to go get it. I pick it up. If we're playing where we can't move, then I stay still, I slide it, I run after it again, But if we are playing when they can move, then I can run all around and slide it. And we practice that with our bowling, so they have to bowl or underhand throw. They cannot sidearm or throw it overhand. So that is beanbag tag or toe tag. So super fun game. So those are four tagging games. There's so many great tagging games out there that I will make a video of some other ones later in the year. But hopefully you were able to pick up at least one, tweak it to fit your needs. But don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel. I do put new content out every week. And thank you so much for your support, and make it a great day.